Alright you guys, well, earlier I practiced my 200 high kicks, the go now tech, and then Joe came in and now I got to work on a very important aspect, the fence, for the most part, and Joe was working on his efficiency. So what we did today was we did lead and rear three-pointers. So for 2 minutes, Joe, he was throwing the same three-pointer over and over. His objective was to break my defense. He wanted to throw effective three-pointers. Now, me, I understand what the three-pointer is, so I'm trying to work on different aspects so that I'm not doing the same defensive movement that's successful 100% of the time. Sometimes I do more of the traditional Bajon with my hands here. Sometimes I do a peekaboo style, turtle defense, maybe here. Maybe I do a drop arm. And a couple times I was willing to let my hands drop and see if I can move my head and use my footwork to get out of the way. So Joe, give us some insight on what you felt about this training session today.
It was harder when you would miss a punch than yes. It was typically, because you got to reset and it's more energy expended. I was surprised how out of breath you got trying to chase it after like a minute and a half or 2 minutes.
And that's the thing, I wasn't hitting you back. Exactly. I wanted you to break my defense down, you know. I even kind of did different setups until you broke my defense, in, which forced me to do a different defense. Now, how did it feel like setting me up?
Setting up, I was also surprised how much of a gas it was on you.
Yeah.
Because you're used to, you know, after 2 minutes throwing punches, your arm's a little bit tired, and then you're gonna get beat for another minute as you set them up. It's tough.
And that's the thing for me, it's a great condition because, you know, to be on the receiving end for 2 minutes straight of combinations and then to do a 1 minute of, you know, Joe, he holds up his gloves and I hit the same combination. It could be a jab, cross, hook, cross, hook, cross, jab, cross, uppercut, cross. But either way, at the last minute, I'm just throwing volume and I'm working on proper execution and keeping my hands where they need to be, not, you know, dropping my hands and anticipating and leaving myself open. And hopefully in the videos you get to see that, you know, when I do my combinations, you know, the hands were properly set. So it was a good workout. Definitely got hit plenty of times. But that's part of it because it's not just all offense. You know, if you get in there with someone and you never practice the defense, and you're not willing to allow your partner to let his hands go free and see whether or not your capabilities are where they need to be, then you can't be upset or disappointed when something happens and, you know, in the real situation you weren't able to take care of yourself or to take care of the situation. Alright guys, well, I hope you guys enjoyed the video. And again, as I always say to anyone who's doing martial arts, don't allow yourself to have a false sense of security. A technique is only as good as the individual that's willing to practice it in a high stress, chaotic setting, not in a low stress, orderly conduct per se in like a lot of classes. So you gotta put the gloves on, put the safety gear on, go at it, at least build up realistic understanding of whether or not you can apply your techniques. Okay, you guys take care.
Don't you have a cross hook?
Yeah, just follow the whole time. When you're working on that palm of instrument, I'm going to work on the press, just a palm of instrument.
Hook to the head, right?
That's
the volume.
That's the volume.
Right.
Sorry. Now I'm going to put the failure test me up, so quick, I'm going to start my ground cross, so stop here.
Okay. But you can throw both of them over here?
Yeah, no, right here. So. That way, I think it's important. So this is bring this, like.
So figure it out.
Not far away, but close.
Okay.
Because this is your head, this is your head, so your head is right there.
Sorry.
Good. stuff you do, but then help. Where do we go?
Well, hey, when you split my hand, you get through.